So imagine you're taking a walk in nature. It's exciting for us. We can see, you know, the trees, we can hear the bees. It's relaxing and enjoyable. Now, suddenly take away your vision and your hearing. Instead of being this beautiful experience, it becomes a very scary thing. And that's what deaf blindness is.
I just got to Wesley's house, so let's go on in and say hi.
Hey, Wes.
Yeah, hi.
So an intervener is a deafblind's access to the world. We take all the visual information along with everything that is heard and turn it into information that they can understand.
Watch your stand up. In.
Okay, Sandra's able to give him tactile cues and auditory cues and help him make more sense of his world so it's not so threatening.
He's been doing really great with his counting, so we're gonna do some counting today.
4, 5. This would be an example of wood chips for going outside. They can feel, and then they know, okay, we're going outside. This changes things drastically for a deafblind kid, because if I just grab their hand, you know, that's a scary experience, being taken somewhere and having no idea where you're gonna end up.
Nice day out today.
A lot of times, people see these kids and have very low expectations. And they often don't get the chance to prove themselves. For him, counting was something that proved to the world that, you know, there's something in there.
Okay, Wesley, press the switch when I hit the drum 5 times. And we were all like, oh.
He was consistently.
Like, that was really purposeful.
Like, what do you mean I can't count?
Wesley can count up to 40 using his drum and add the lower numbers. The fact that he can count and spell proves that he can understand complex thoughts and ideas.
Nice day, buddy.
People in the world treat him so much differently now.
6.
Once you 7. Have communication, you suddenly have power. You can finally advocate for yourself. You can finally make active decisions in what you want. What do you want to eat? Where do you want to go?
I just arrived where I'm meeting my very first deafblind student again. I started working with him 10 years ago and worked with him for 2 years, then moved, so it's been a very long time. I'm so excited to see him again, and I can't wait.
No matter what, the kids will surprise you. Naya is a group of basically interveners who have come together to advocate for deafblind kids.
One of the struggles in our field is that we're so few that
as a group, we're able to change the lives of, you know, millions of deafblind kids.
She's coming in with a kid like Wesley and bringing the world to them and bringing out what's inside him out for the rest of the world to see. There's so much more going on in there. He has a lot to show us and guide us.
Spreading the word that there are people out there that can, you know, teach these deafblind kids and can adapt things and give them a chance to see the world in a totally new way.